What he did was he took a container, a closed container, and inside that he filled certain fluid. Now with the help of pedal wheel arrangement, he put a steerer inside it, such that if I'm dropping this weight down, with the help of these pulleys, this steerer will rotate. That means the work will be done on the system. He insulated the whole vessel. Initially, the vessel was insulated. Now what he did was he dropped the weight. Now on dropping the weight, obviously this steerer will rotate. And as a result of which, the work is done on the system, on the gases, on the fluids. And the temperature of that gas will increase. Initial temperature is, let's suppose, T0. Final temperature after doing certain work on it becomes, let's suppose, T1. And the atmospheric temperature is, let's suppose, T0. Okay, so the temperature increased from T0 to T1. Now, because the vessel was insulated, so the internal, the energy of the system increased and the temperature of the system increased. And as a result of which, he measured the work done. Work done kitna hai, wo bhi measure kiya ja sakta hai. How? Total weight into the distance which is dropped. That means mg into the distance, suppose h height, it is dropped. The total work done on the system can be measured from that. Now, what he did was, he removed the insulation. Now, there is a difference between temperature of inside the container and outside the container. Difference of temperature. Inside, we are having T1 temperature and outside, we are having T0 temperature. Now, that particular gas was exposed to atmosphere whose temperature is T0. So, obviously, because of this difference in temperature, the energy will flow in the form of heat. As we have already discussed, the energy will flow in the form of heat because of temperature difference. And it will be flowing, the heat will flow up to the point when the final temperature of this gas becomes T0. That means this is a whole cycle. Initially, the temperature was T0. After doing certain work on it, the temperature becomes T1. And after that, again, when we expose this to the atmosphere, temperature again became T0. This becomes a whole cycle. And in this process, he measured the heat transfer. Heat transfer can be measured because constant volume process. This is a constant volume process. And with the help of MCV delta, we can measure the heat transfer. What he found was total summation of W in a complete cycle is directly proportional to summation of Q in the complete cycle. Total summation of W, total algebraic sum of work interaction in the complete cycle was directly proportional to algebraic sum of heat interaction in the whole cycle. Now, in order to remove this proportionality, he used a constant J, what he named as Joule's constant, as his name was Joule. Okay, so he gave one constant J. Now, the reason he was getting this proportionality sign and the Joule constant was key at that particular time, the unit of heat and work was different. But later on, हमने दोनों की यूनिट जैसे ही सेम हुई हीट ऑफ वर्क की, देन लेटर ऑन ही फाउंड दैट दिस जूल कॉन्स्टेंट वी टुक एज वन एंड फाइनली वी गॉट वॉट समेशन ऑफ डब्ल्यू साइकिल वॉज इक्वल टू समेशन ऑफ क्यू साइकिल. दैट मीन्स साइक्लिक इंटीग्रल ऑफ डब्ल्यू इन अ कंप्लीट साइकिल, समेशन ऑफ एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ डब्ल्यू वर्क डन इन अ कंप्लीट साइकिल इज इक्वल टू एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ हीट इन अ कंप्लीट साइकिल. एंड दिस एक्चुअली बिकेम द official statement of first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics says that in a complete cycle, total algebraic sum of work transfer is equal to algebraic sum of heat transfer.